Hello guys, welcome to my channel. Today, I would like to discuss about the development of Sriwijaya or Silivosi. But before I started this video, I would like to give you notification that please subscribe and push notification button. Also comment and click like for the advancement of this channel, so in the future we can give you another good topic about the kingdoms, especially kingdom in Southeast Asia and of course kingdom around the world. Let's find out in my video. The development of Sriwijaya or Silivosi. Sriwijaya or Silivosi started sending embassies sometime between 670 and 673, not in 695 as George Codes considered. So what I would like to deliver in this topic is the Japanese historian point of view about how Sriwijaya was built and where Sriwijaya was built, and different from other historian, for example different from George Codes. Okay, we continue this topic. George Codes says perhaps it was also the king Jayanasa who sent the embassy of 695 to China, the first one from Sriwijaya, for which we have a definite date. Before this embassy, we have a folk mention of embassies beginning with the period 670 to 673. After it, we know of embassy of the 702 and 716 and 724 in the name of the king Silitolopamo or Sri Indravarman, and of 728 and 742 in the name of king Liu Teng Wei Kung. George Codes misunderstand here or tells a lie. The first embassy from Sriwijaya was without doubt between 670 to 673, yeah. Xianxiang years, and 695. Sriwijaya did not send mission to China. In 695, the Tang court issued to provide food to the tributary countries for their return journey, for instance to South India, North India, Persia and Arab. And 6 months worth of food to Sriwijaya, Chenla and Kaling for 5 months worth of food, and to Champa 3 months worth of food. According to the Chefu Yuan Gui, Sriwijaya or Silivosi sent the first envoy to the Tang court between 670 to 673, and thereafter from 701, 716, 724, and 727, and also 742. After 742, the name of Silivosi had not appeared until 904. Yijing left Canton at November 671, for India via Sriwijaya, where he recognized existing considerable number of Buddhist temple and respectable monks. The location of Sriwijaya was undoubtedly Panpan, and its capital was Chaya. According to the Tongdian, compiled by Duyo in 801, there are 10 monasteries where Buddhist monks and nuns study their canon. They eat all types of meat but refrain from wine. There is also one monastery of Daoists, religiously advanced devotees who partake neither of meat nor wine. They study the classic of the Asura king, but they enjoy no great respect. The ordinary Buddhist priests are commonly called Bhikkhu or Bhikkhu, the others Tan. In the Chinese Annal of Tang, we cannot find any other state which had more Buddhist temple than Panpan or Chaya area on the west coast of the Malay Peninsula. Kedah had some Buddhist temple, but Yijing thought nothing of the Buddhist temple. On the east coast, Nakhon Sitamarat was a large port city, but there are not so many archaeological remains belonging to the Tang era. In Palembang, there exists some remains of Buddhist temple and Buddha images, but we cannot compare them with those of Chaya. According to the Su Fanxi, published in 1225 AD, only two Buddhist temples exist in Java. Probably Yijing, the priest, had visited Chaya in a Persian merchant ship which usually stopped over the commercially frequent port city. Before leaving China, Yijing consulted his itinerary plan with several supporters, including high government officials. Yijing could have gathered sufficient information beforehand about the Buddhism of Southeast Asia and Sriwijaya or Silivosi. The king of Sriwijaya might be one of the descendants of Funan kings, as George Codes suggested. They might have founded the new state named Sriwijaya or Silivosi peacefully, and the Tang dynasty accepted the new order in the Malay Peninsula. Chitu sent 3 consecutive embassies to the Sui dynasty, and the emperor sent the special envoy to Chitu. But the Chinese chronicle kept silence about the fate of Chitu. As we know, Sriwijaya continued expansion of its territory to the southwards along the Strait of Malacca, the southeast of Sumatra, including Palembang and Jambi, around 680s. Then finally occupied Kaling or Holing in the central Java. Sriwijaya sent embassies several times, but after 742, the name of Sriwijaya also mysteriously disappeared from the Chinese chronicle without any explanation. However, the Tang court did not seem to recognize the disappearance of Silivosi. Originally, Holing might be pronounced as Kaling, even though the modern Chinese pronunciation is Holing. The name of Kaling had, without doubt, somewhat relation with Kalinga, an ancient dynasty on the east coast of India, now Orissa district. Kaling sent embassies in 640, 647, 648, 666. And in 670, if Kala was misspelled of Kaling, the last envoy of Kaling or Sanjaya was the same year. Since then, the name of Kaling was not seen in the chronicle of the Tang for nearly 100 years. It appeared again in 768 after the name of Sriwijaya disappeared since 742 and Shailendra established hegemony among Sriwijaya group since 768 or earlier year. I think that's all for me at this point about the development of Sriwijaya Empire. Still we have so many unsolved mystery of Sriwijaya Empire, and this one that I told you in this video is one of the opinion of the Japan historian that believe Sriwijaya Empire have capital city in Chaya, Thailand, and meanwhile the other area of Sriwijaya is the vassal state that from Thailand they conquer another state like Palembang, Jambi, and Malay Peninsula, and the other. But it's not the final opinion. So many historians also believe that Sriwijaya capital city in Malay Peninsula, and most historian believe that Sriwijaya capital is in Palembang or in Jambi. But still in many debates, and some historian even believe that the capital city is always moving from century to century in order to have a more agility in defense tactic or aspect. I think that's all for me at this point. Don't forget to click like, subscribe, and push notification button, and also leave comment if you like to ensure that our channel will be continue in the future. Thank you for your attention. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and see you on my next video.